everybody doing?
Good.
Good. I am, it says 2:15 on the schedule, but I'm going to go ahead and jump into it. And mine is not going to take a super long time. And it is kind of open format here to, if you have a question about something, feel free to jump in. This is all about helping you out. And some of the people who are in here have been there already and done it. So feel free to add in to me. I've got several parents in here that have done the club before. So if I miss something, all I'm trying to do with this is give you a good picture of what it looks like during the season as you're going to games and tournaments and those kinds of things. And then what you can expect for that. So I'm going to kind of go through that. And I've got it videoing, so for parents that couldn't make it as well. So I'm going to use a microphone just for that. So tell me if it's too loud. Is that good for everybody? Okay, just making sure. So hopefully that'll help the video with that. And I'm going to go ahead and get started. So first off, in the new club is the idea of when do you get tournament information. Okay, if you're not familiar with it, you get tournament information that comes the Wednesday before. Now, obviously, the schedule is set, so if you haven't seen those are on our website. With each team, they have their schedule at the bottom of the page. They should have been emailed out to you as well. If that hasn't happened, just look for it on the website. But with that, what it actually looks like on Wednesday before, we'll get the information because what they do is they seed teams throughout the season. You get reseeded every week based on the results of tournaments. And so from that, you're ranked within the region. And based on rankings, you get reseeded for every tournament. So whether you're a first seed, second seed, third seed, et cetera, going down through. So to be able to set the schedule for what times you actually play on the weekend, they have to have that information going into it. So it takes time to compile that from Saturday before the next week. So you Saturday through Tuesday, get until Tuesday to compile those results. And then so setting the schedule on Wednesday for the next week. So with that, we'll send that information out to the communications team parent, and we'll have the team parent meeting after this as well. So if you're in for the team parent meeting, that'll be right after for this as well. And so schedules, you'll get the start time, arrival time. So your team coach will tell you, hey, so if it's start time at 8, they'll say, okay, be there by 7:30 or whatever, whichever time they want you to get there, right, ahead of it to make sure that you're there on time. You'll have who the opponents are, and in a minute I'm going to show you an example bracket of this so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. You can also find this online on the Wednesday before. It'll be, depending on which tournament it's on, either srva.org, which is our, they'll have the information if it's hosted through SRVA. If it's hosted by, like Big South, for example, is on Sport Ranch, so you can find the information on that. And then we go to a couple of tournaments as well that the information will be on something called ABS. And I'll be glad to help with that information. If anybody's like, I just can't figure out what you just said, I remember what you said, I'll be glad to show you. No problem on that. So it'll say who you're playing. Sometimes it'll show the black bracket, a little bit what the bracket play looks like. You don't always know, and I'll go over one-day tournament versus two-day tournament here in just a minute, what they look like. Order of play, ref and break assignments. Okay, and what would all look like. Specific location, so your team's gym location. Sometimes you don't know exactly, like for example, our Peachtree Classics that some of our teams are going to, they're hosted at 5 or 6 different gyms. So we don't know which gym you're going to be assigned to until the week before. So it might that they're all in the same Alpharetta, Kennesaw area, but you don't know which gym it will be until that week. So you'll get to know that, and you'll be given that in the location. Gym specifics, so can you have chairs there? Can you bring them in, like Tsunami, for example? They do not let you bring chairs inside. That's one of their rules. And that's because of the fire code marshal for their place. So there's things like that you have to be aware of. Food specifics, can you have a food table or not? And Gail's going to go over what a food table looks like for you here in just a little bit, too. Admissions, parking costs, is there a cost to park there? At the Big South, there will be, right? Certain ones won't have. Usually, if you're at a high school, they don't have a gym. They don't have a parking cost. But usually, most terms do have an admission, so be prepared for that, having an admission to get in for the term. We can determine it. This will be sent by the food team parent, food sign up, if you're, you know, if they're able to bring food, okay? Helping to bring food for the team, those kinds of things. Okay, typical day tournament for one day, usually the arrival is between 7 to 7:30. That's what you can expect for one day. So you're there and expect to be there the whole day, right? It's a full day event. You will use the park sometime in between 4 and 7 p.m., right? It's usually kind of, that's a long gap, I realize, but it depends on how well you do, right? If your team is doing well, you could be there all the way to the end of the championship game, right? If you don't make it to bracket play, you could be finished early. But you won't know until the day is half for that. So be prepared for a full day. Don't make any, you know, big plans for the night of the tournament, because you don't know. You might not be able to make it back on that. Matches, you can expect 4 to 7 matches, depending on how well you do again. That mixed in with sitting repping. So when I say sitting repping, what that means is, as the days are long, say you may play at 8 o'clock, ref a different match at 9, sit, have a break, come back and play again at 10, right? So at 11, that would be, so sitting at 10. You could have a schedule where I'll show you that in a second, an example of what that looks like, how you would be sitting and doing that. So depending on the style of the one-day tournament, first and second place teams, like I was just saying, may be the only teams that advance, right? But if you're in a gold silver bracket, for example, that, you know, first, second, third, and fourth would be advancing. So there's different types of brackets, and those will be specified beforehand, so you know what to expect going in. Please know that your team may ref the last bracket play game even after they finish last game. So this is an example. Say your team went in, they made it to bracket play, and then they lost in the semifinals. You ended up being the third place team. You may be the team that has to ref the championship game. So don't think, oh, I'm done. Make sure that you have to, you know, stay in the ref. What we do with that as a club is we ask just all players to stay to help ref, because the way that works is, you know, it allows everyone to contribute and continue to team bond, work together, and help each other out. And if you have, say they have 3 matches, you can rotate. You know, not everybody has to just work all 3 sets of that. So you have to work all parts of that. So with that, so please do expect to stay advantage. That's an example of 1-day tournament. 2-day tournament, Saturday arrival. It depends on if you're a morning wave or afternoon wave. Morning wave, same as the 1-day tournament, right? Usually about 7 to 7:30. Afternoon wave, usually 12 to 1, somewhere is where you're looking to arrive for those. And the departure for the Saturday would be the 1 to 2. You're finishing up your pool play, right? So that's the beginning part of it before. And then afternoon wave, you 7:30 to 9, somewhere in that period, depending on how long the games take. One thing to remember with this is, and when I show you the schedule in a minute, it will show you times, but the times, if a game goes longer, then your time may be later. So for example, a game started at 8 and went until 9:30, your game said you're starting at 9, you would actually start at 9:30 sometimes, right? And that does happen, so be aware that the times are not exact. They may start a little bit earlier. It goes the other way as well. So one team comes in and they just win very quickly, right? And so they finish up very quickly, so they're done at 8:30. You should be ready at the court, ready to play, because they'll be ready for you to jump in and start. Okay. Saturday matches, for a 2-day tournament, you're getting 3 to 4 on those with sitting repping mixed in. All teams advance to Sunday. And I don't have on here, I didn't mention Big South, it is a national qualifier. So it is different on that. There's 3 days on Big South. There's a Friday, a Saturday, and a Sunday. So you're going for Friday for your pool play. Depending on how you do on Friday pool play, you may be moved into something called, you know, a flight, basically, moving in for the second day of it. And if you did not do well, they'll move you into a lower level. And that's not particularly a bad thing. You know, but Big South, you're playing a lot of really good teams. So, I mean, this is a national qualifier, so teams are coming all around the nation to play. So for that, it's not, it really does just, you know, it depends on who you get matched up with. You could do really well, you could not do as well. So depending, and for Big South, that is talking, that's for the one seams that are going to that one, and the 17 twos are also going to that. So, but continuing, so all teams will advance to the second or third day, depending on if it's a national qualifier or a two-day tournament like that, to be able to have the bracket play on the last day. Note for that, usually when you're in this kind of situation where parents, you want smaller quantities of food tables because the schedule is more compact, there's less breaks, so you don't need to have the full spread that you would get for a one day. You need to have specific things that are really going to, you know, bring a lot for the, you know, for what they are there. And they'll talk about that in the nutrition seminar as well as with, you know, Miguel talking a little bit here. So continuing two-day tournaments, Sunday arrival. So there are no waves on Sundays on two-day tournaments. This is dependent upon your results from Saturday. So, you know, if you did really well, you might have a later start time, or it just depends on how it's broken up. You don't know. You could have done really well and have an 8 a.m. start time. But these are all divided up, and you'll be able to see at the end of the day on Saturday, you'll know, okay, what's coming up for Sunday based on how well you did. Could be anywhere from 7 to 12, right? And so we've had all of that happen, you know, during that. So you really don't know what's going to be until it happens. Departure, this on Sundays for bracket play, this is either a single elimination or you get a consolation game as well. So depending on the tournament, there are oftentimes you could be, you know, win, continue on, go all the way to championship, play till 2 p.m. or you could lose at 8 a.m. and be done for the day, right? So it just depends on how well it goes and what the tournament is that and happens with that. Usually, if you lose, you ref before you go home. That's kind of the way Sunday matches are set up. You lose, you ref the person right after you play. So that's pretty normal for that. Occasionally, there is, like I said, a loser's bracket or a consolation match. And note with that, consolation match can be scheduled very late. So we do not have the option to not play these without serious financial penalties. So it is a big thing. When you enter a tournament, we have to make sure we're finishing out what we go for, which makes sense. But with that in mind, that's kind of an idea of what you can expect for a tournament. And if you played club sports before, a lot of times if any sport, you've seen this happen. If you're new to volleyball or in this first time ever doing any kind of a club sport, then you'll get the hang of it pretty fast. And I'm always, you know, glad to help. You understand anything, you have any questions, but there are other parents who have been there and done that, and they could tell you, you know, even better than I could because they've been from the parent side of what it looks like for you there. So reffing those same as one-day tournaments, you may ref after playing either day. So pool versus bracket play. So you heard me talking about pool versus bracket play. Let me break that down a little bit more for you so you know exactly what I'm talking about here. In pool play, this is going to have your games will start at 4-4. So you're like, well, why does it start at 4-4? That helps the time for the pool play so they can keep matches rolling. So instead of 0-0, and usually you're getting two sets that you're going to be playing. So that means even if you split 1-1, they're going to tally up those. So how many wins did you get all day? How many losses did you have all day? And that's tallied to determine seeding, who goes home, who moves on the tournament bracket, etc. So bracket play then usually. So this is the
pool play that go off of points scored.
Yes, and so. And so that's a good thing to think about as well. Sometimes, so you could end up in a situation where, say, you and another team both tied in second place, right? You both had the same record for, so say 3-3. You both ended up 3-3 for the day. They would take it down to, depending on the tournament, sometimes they take it based on the point differential. So if you beat teams better than the other team did it, basically, adding up all the points. And that takes a little bit of time to tally all of that, but they keep up with it throughout the day. And the other thing that they may do sometimes is they may have a playoff match where you would play against that team to see who gets to move on. And so it just depends. Those things are set before the tournament. So you'll know if they'll have – and I'll flip. You see – it's kind of hard to see right there. I can see a little better. But if you look right in here, you can see the 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm not going to go over what everything is, but it tells you specifically what would happen based on if there was a tie, that kind of stuff. So those will be written, and you can find those on the walls in the gyms where you're playing. Usually they'll have those posted for you, and you'll see tournament directors walking up and marking on those after games, or you have the scores reported for you. On the left, you can see this is an example pool play where Lanier being number two right there on pool A. You see they would have played at 8:30, and then you notice that the times are not written down for the rest of the times because they don't guarantee it's going to be at a certain time. They just, you know, so 8:30 they would have played, and then they would have sat, played again. So that's just one example there. You can see how that's set up. And then they would have reffed the fifth match and then sat, and then they would have, on number seven, they would have played again and then reffed the eighth and then sat and then played in the tenth. Okay? Anybody have any questions about that? Because that might look like gibberish, right? You might, if it does, let me point out this point real quick. So you can kind of see, like, two, their second one near. And then you can see, so the matches that they're playing, and then so 2 versus 5, 1 versus 4, and it goes through who's playing when, and then ref when you and ref. Did that help a little bit? Maybe pointing it out. Yeah, it's easy for me to see on my computer, probably not as easy to see from y'all there. Okay, so I'll go back for a second, make sure. Okay, so bracket play, usually best of three. Unless it's start after 6 p.m. So you may have a situation where you come in, you're like, the games went really long. Started bracket play after 6 p.m. So at that point, sometimes they do not do the best out of three. Third set's always the 15 with that. Multiple brackets at some tournaments. So you may have a gold, silver, bronze. You could be playing in a bronze bracket, and you could win the championship for a bronze bracket. And that's a great thing, really, honestly. We try to get in as many gold, silver, or gold, silver, bronze brackets because it gives girls opportunity to have success. So even if you don't, even if you don't win the gold bracket, you can win the silver bracket, and that is, you can really be, excited about winning any bracket because that's just, it's not easy to do. We play a lot of good competition, and we have done well, but it's still fun to, it's good to, have all that option, all those options. So top one or two teams go to gold. Third to silver, fourth to bronze, fifth goes home. That's an example of a typical when you have all the way down to bronze. And then here's an example. And what I'll do with this PowerPoint as well, this will be on our website afterwards. We made a page already ready to go for this. I've got a video, and so I'll put the video up there, and I'll put this up there so you can kind of look through and probably see it a little bit better than you can right now, too, for that. So here's just a couple examples. The one over here was an example of pool play. This is an example you can kind of see how, I'm going to just walk up and show you real quick. So you can kind of see the teams is blocked out off of what seed they are. And then that would be them playing against number two. And you can see who number two is. And they write down the scores. This is the kind of thing you'll see on the wall where it had the scores they're kept up with, and then they'll have a tally, how many games they won, how many games they lost. And then it'll have who moves on here at the end, writing down. This one ended up, which you can't see here, but our team ended up, they were third seed going in, and they ended up tying for second and ended up playing a playoff match. Like I said, we talked about point differential versus playoff match. They played a playoff match and moved on in that situation. Here's an example of bracket play that you might see on the website, where it will show times and when the next match would happen. So this is one from, this was Icebreakers. And in this tournament, we ended up going to the championship game. So I'll kind of walk you through what that looks like. So we started off here playing at 12 p.m. and then and did not play again until 3, right? So you may have that as a situation. Sometimes that's a long break. So one of the things you need to understand is and be prepared for that can happen, right? And you be prepared to need to wait and have that time in between to be able to know. So they finished that and then played again in the championship at 4. So this is a Sunday match after, so they didn't, you know, so that ended up, during this time, they did not have a ref because they won in this situation. If they would have lost here, then they would have had to ref here. Okay, so it just, and now it could have been this team that had to ref. Sometimes it depends on which team finishes last, meaning like not time-wise, right, who finished last. And sometimes it's preset on who finishes. I'll give you a couple examples there. All right, so helpful hints. So, terms, just for your players, what do you make sure that they're bringing? Make sure they have all uniforms. Now, the 12s only have the white, but every other team has 2 uniforms. So make sure that you have all uniforms, have additional socks, make sure that you have, you know, an extra sports bra, right? Make sure that you've got any personal items that you need. Oh, before I get to that, contacts. If you wear contacts, like I wear contacts, always make sure to have an extra pair and bring the glasses. Make sure you got both, because then maybe a situation where her eye gets irritated or something and she needs to wear glasses to be able to keep playing. I had that happen to me in baseball 1 year. I mean, it just, you know, tore a contact, and then I'm like, you know, trying to hit like this. But my mom was good. She brought stuff. So it was not, you know, she took care of it. So make sure you got those. Personal items, deodorant, lip balm, tampons, hair ties, water bottle. Make sure you're taking care of all those things. Wearing Lanier gear, right? You're at a tournament, so wear your Lanier gear, right? We're going to make sure that you got that. So, you know, wear that. It might be cold entering or leaving. You know, you can obviously wear a coat over it if you don't have enough. That's no problem. Yeah, but do wear it. Hey, we want to represent and be proud to be a part of what we're doing. Don't wear your volleyball shoes outside. This is just a good tip. You will wear out the life of your volleyball shoes very quickly if you're wearing it outside, right? They will start getting slicker. So make sure girls know that, you know, hey, get slides instead or something, right? Extra pair of tennis shoes, slides, something that, you know, slides is what a lot of the girls do. They just slip them on, you know, slip them on after a match if they're going to go outside, and then you put the shoes back on and come inside. So consider ankle braces. We don't require ankle braces. Some clubs do make you wear that, but consider that, especially if you have a front row player who's doing a lot of jumping where they can be coming down after blocking onto people's feet or different things. It's real easy to twist and hurt those, so definitely consider that. Rest and refuel. The nutrition seminar tonight, we're going to have details, really specific details about this. Mary Beth spent a lot of time looking into researching, consulting people about how to do this in a good way. So we've got that tonight for y'all as well. Make sure that they're doing that. It is crucial, the refuel especially, is crucial to make sure that they're continuing to eat throughout the day. An example was brought up, Mary Beth was talking to me about, she's like one of her girls at practice the other night, even. Like at practice, they had not eaten since breakfast, and then they just did the sports conditioning performance training, and then they had practice afterwards. She was like, and they were all dragging, and so had the conversation with them, girls, hey, you've got to make sure you're eating throughout the day to be prepared, you know, for this intense training. Same idea at tournament. They're wearing out for hours straight, trying to, you know, do the best they can and win, you know, and play well and do everything. And then, you know, the day stretches out from 8 to 6, and they don't realize if you don't eat. So make sure that you're continuing to eat. You know, so that's go on that ball. Breaks. Great time to continue team bonding. So, you know, spend it with teammates. That's a good thing to do. Hey, join together. Obviously, they're going to come over and hang out with y'all some too. That's great. You know, it's, you know, spend some time with your parents. But use that time to build your team, right, to help each other grow and get to know each other. And, you know, I know Mary Beth will do, she'll play games with them sometimes and come up with stuff just to get their mind off of what's happened in the last match or something. You know, just whatever. So just help. That's a good thing to be able to do. We have a great opportunity this year. We're going to have several tournaments where we're going to be at the same place with other Lanier teams. Like Gatlinburg, for example, this first one coming up. Go take your team together. Go cheer on another Lanier team. right? You know, that builds everybody's confidence, right? You know, because you're getting to cheer them on, and then they do well, something happens, and it comes back, and they cheer you on, you know, it goes all around. So it's just a good thing to do. If it's nice weather, go outside for a little bit, right? Get you some vitamin D, right? It's a good another good thing to do. So, all right. Parents, health tips, hints for y'all. Okay, if they allow chairs, bring a chair. You will want it. I brought my first year with Mary Beth doing this, and before I was a director, when I was just the husband watching a coach, and I didn't have to talk or do or worry about anything. I've had a nice camping chair that I had to lay up my feet and put my head back and relax, and went to sleep a couple times in between, right? You know, so it's a long day for you too, right? You're going in, you're going to be there all day long, and you know, think about these things, right? How can you take advantage of taking that? Be sure to bring some cash, because you will, there'll be gate admission. Sometimes concessions, some places, so you know, if you say, hey, I didn't bring enough food, let me make sure I get something else, that's a good thing to do. If you have Lanier spirit wear, wear it. You know, it helps pick out each other, right? If you don't have one, hey, wear something green, right? That helps. You know, we're green or white. You know, something in the same family there, right? It kind of help you, you know, for that. Cheer, yes, for parents, yes, you can cheer. Cheer on your team. Cheer on good things, right? Anything that you see that can help grow, you know, build the confidence of the girls. Hey, you know, cheer for great volleyball. If another team makes a great play, hey, great job, right? You know, we want to build that all around, okay? Helps in that manner as well. Expect a lot of noise. That's something, if you've never been to a club volleyball tournament, they are loud. They're loud. There's a lot of people. They're in enclosed space. A lot of noise. Teams are cheering. There's whistles blowing. I mean, you know, you got a bunch of different games happening, so be prepared for that. If you've been in gyms before, it won't be any big deal to you, right? It doesn't really, I've been in it all the time, so for me, it's just kind of second nature, but, you know, be prepared for that. Patience, sometimes seating can slow things down and can cause, like I said, a lot of downtime, so be prepared for that. One thing that I think I've got on here somewhere, but bring a book, right? Bring you something, something to read, something to work on if you need, you know, something to kill some time, because there will be some good time for you to kill as well. Let's see. Get to know your other team parents. I know from other team parents that are in here, they can tell you these are some special bonds that you make as parents. You get to know these other parents that you might have never come in contact with. And it really becomes some really good friendships that a lot of people will last for a long time afterwards. I can tell you just from experience, we have parents that still get together and spend time together, even though their daughters aren't playing together anymore, right? And they're not, you know, just not even playing volleyball anymore at this point. So, they're still friends, and they like to get together. So, that, you know, take advantage of that for yourself. The ride home chat. This is one thing that we encourage with your daughters. One of the points of this for them is, hey, love playing, right? We want them to love playing volleyball, right? Obviously, you want to get better. You want to win. All that goes into it, too. But when it comes down to it, you want your daughter to love what she does, right? So when you talk to her about it, I just love watching you play. I love watching you play. I love how much you dig in and want to do this. Or what can you pick up the stuff like that, right, that you can think of from that match that will build your daughter up. And let her recap, right? She may want to complain about something. That's fine. Let her be the one to do that, right? You know, and if you have something that you need to bring out, hey, do it later, right? Let that day play out, okay? Little ones, I have gone for the past 3 years now with a little one in tow to tournament, and now two for the past 2 years, but. So I have a lot of experience with this. If you need some tips, I can help you with that as well. Just come talk to me. Ask me about what do you do for your 3 and your 1-year-old that you got right now. Right? You know, that's there are things you can do to help them at tournaments too. And there are other parents that have more than I do. I've seen parents with 4 or 5 in tow, and I'm like, I don't know how she does it. That's amazing. So talk to them too, right? That'll help you out. So, all right. Conduct at tournaments. And this is common sense a little bit, but just shoot for being courteous and respectful. You represent Lanier when you're there. So please be courteous to the refs, professional and player refs. One thing to note on this, it never, you'll see that on the next tab. Keep score, because you want to know what's going on. You can't see it. Keep up with the score. But don't yell at the ref to change. It doesn't help. It actually makes it worse. The ref is more likely to call something on our team if he's getting yelled at by our team parents. So that's just something to remember. And you know, they're instructed not to listen. And the girls at the table that are actually keeping score are going to be another team. So if you're yelling at them, it's like yelling at your own daughter, really, almost, right? Because you're yelling at somebody else's daughter at that point, right? So it's not really great. Now, and you're going to get frustrated. I guarantee you, I've been there. I'll raise my hand. I've been frustrated. Oh, they missed 2 points right there. That should have been to us. But it's okay. Well, they're going to do their best to work it out. You know, there are ways that a coach can talk to a ref about it, right? So, you know, that there's other ways to do it without you know, you getting at the player. And that's just, you know, unlike basketball or some other sports, sometimes, like, you know, you're yelling in stands all the time. Volleyball is a little bit different, right? They don't really want that as much. Okay, of players, of coaches, of other spectators, you know, just being respectful. Okay. And I'm talking about keeping score. Oh, last one on that, conflict. please do remember, there is guaranteed at some point this season with 11 teams to be something that doesn't work exactly how it needed to work. If that is the case, please remember the 24-hour rule with that, with your coaches. Take time and, you know, take time to digest everything and then come back and set up a meeting on it. And that's no problem. I'd be glad to come sit in, help do anything. Unless it is an immediate, very, very serious issue, right? If something comes up where it's like it has to be handled that day, you call me and I will help make sure it gets taken care of. Okay? That's kind of the way we address those things. But if it's like, oh, I don't understand why something didn't happen the way it should, this didn't happen this way, that, just take a little bit of time, just kind of chew on it, think on it, and then come back to it. That just helps everybody, gives coach time to not, you know, we want them at the tournament to focus on coaching, right, and focus on investing in your daughters during that time. So we don't want anything else to be worried about during that. So I can worry about other stuff if I need to, right? That's part. I don't coach any team, so you don't have to worry about that, right? You get a hold of me, I'm there. I know if I'm not at your tournament, that means I'm at another tournament, and I will come to yours if I need to. You know, I mean, that's kind of, you know, unless I'm, you know, 4 hours away or something, right? But, you know, I will do my best to be, you know, there, addressed still. You know, that's just kind of a, y'all probably already knew all that anyway, but that's just a thing that I make sure that I cover so everybody understands. So that's covers the basic of, you know, of some basics you can expect. So parents that have been with us, what have I missed about weekends, tournaments, what to expect, what questions y'all have for me, feel free. I'm open to whatever. So, yes, ma'am. My phone number. Go ahead and grab that. That'll help. You can just text me. Is the easiest way to get it to me. Four scores. As you're watching, you'll see scores at the end, but they'll write it on. There'll be a sheet, usually a sheet of paper in the gym posted, where they'll write down the final scores. You're looking during pool play. It's usually two. You're talking about two different scores you're going to be sending in, and you can just send it to me. Easiest way to do that is, you send to me, you know, we won 25-16, 25-14, or we lost 25, or 14-25, just do opposite, right? Yeah, we'd always be the first one, right? You just give us our score first, that way it's easy to remember that. So, we split 25-16, 25-20, or 22-25, something like that. And pretty easy to do on that for me. Good question. Yes, sir.
I need to make sure they include your team, the team that's on there. If you defend, see your score.
Right.
Sometimes
is helpful. And I've tried to do my best to get to know everybody, but we've grown a lot, so I'm still learning. So it's going to take me a little while to make sure I know who everybody's name and everybody. I know all the girls' names. I got that now. So, but my next step is trying to get all y'all. So please give me a little grace as I'm working towards that. Yes.
Send all the one time so you get all the
girls. Yeah, that's the easiest way. Send me the whole, how they did the whole match. Because that's easier to keep up with, too. And who they're playing. If you also send me who they played. Like, for example, say we play Pro League. If you're a 14s team, you say, we won versus Pro League 14-1s or whatever. Right, whoever it was. Yes, Ms. Matt.
If you have several hours of downtime, mm-hmm. are the players or the parents required to stay the entire time at the club, or would they be able to leave, or how?
So parents do not. We encourage staying, but parents obviously go get food. I've been to tournaments and gone and gotten food and come back for. That's fine. We're not holding you to having to be there the whole time. They're with the coach. They're with the team. For girls, they don't need to be leaving. They can obviously go outside, but they don't need, because you just never know when a schedule could change or something. It may say, hey, we got 2 hour break, but it ended up being an hour, or, it just depends on that. A team may drop out or something. That's happened before, too. So you just gotta, girls want to stay, but parents are welcome to come and go. Good question.
Yes, sir.
Parents that have been there, got thoughts or other questions for me? Well, if you think of anything as you're around today, or you're at a tournament, even something like doesn't make sense, ask me. Yes, sir.
Advil, Tylenol, some kind of small medical bag.
Yes.
Rashes.
Yes. Definitely anything that would be helpful for if you know your daughter gets migraines, have migraine medicine ready. That's. Mm-hmm. Just different things like that. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Definitely. So that's if you didn't hear what Dorian was saying, to just if as a team. Talk about what you might need to bring. Have a kit together for a team to bring first aid wise. It's a good thing. I know our coaches. We got to have our coaches try to make sure that they all have a first aid kit, but it may not always include exactly what your daughter needs. And we don't give medicine for them to give it. We don't have that. It's just we have to fix something. Quick. You're bleeding. Let me get you a band-aid. That kind of stuff. Yes, so I'm finished right now, then we're going to, Gail is going to be, she is so graciously offered to, she has been a team parent with us, for 4 years, 5, yeah, I guess, right around that, yeah. So she's been with Mary Beth's team for a couple of years and a couple of other teams with us for a couple of years, and she's it's just great. I've got some other parents in here who've been with us and are just amazing as well, but she's been so kind to offer to come up and do the team parent meeting. So if you're want to hear about that here, you can go ahead and come on up. If you'll hit stop recording and then start it back for Gail.